Hello everyone, I am Manideepa Bera of the Great India School and I am here to explain a chapter of class 7's main course book Buzzword, the first chapter Darwin Diaries. It is an extract from Charles Darwin written by Alan Gibbons. Now let's come to the story or the prose. This is based on the voyage or expedition made by Charles Darwin, the famous naturalist. He wrote the book on the origin of species. He researched over the various species of animals on the world. During his voyage in 1835 to the Galapagos Islands, a boy named James Kinsett was his assistant. The boy was that time only 10 years old. And after 5 years, when he was 15 years old, he wrote all the experiences in his diary. So we will know about the visit or the experiences that Darwin had during his voyage to the Galapagos Island. First of all, let us know about the Galapagos Island. Galapagos Island is a group of islands, 15 group of islands. There are total 15 islands altogether, and all these islands are actually created by the volcanic eruptions. These are located about 600 kilometers away from the equator. Charles Darwin did his voyage by the ship named HMS Beagle, which was a royal ship of that time. At first, they reached to the Chatham Island. The land of the Chatham Island was dark in color, the surface was rough, and it was barren. There were only slanted brushwood, that means the small broken and dried twigs of wood scattered here and there on the island. The weather was hot, but the water around the island was cold. Though the land was barren, in the water around the island there were many fish, sharks, and turtles. The crew members of the ship enjoyed fishing. The author has described that in Chatham Island, they have seen small birds, iguana, and huge Galapagos tortoises. These birds were hopping on the ground or on the land. They were totally unaccustomed of human company. That means they didn't know what human being is. So they were not afraid of the human at all. Though people were present there, they were hopping in the way that it seemed that they can be easily caught. The iguana were seagoing, they were going towards the sea. They were also not afraid of the presence of people over there. And the huge Galapagos tortoises, they were so huge in size that James himself sat on the back of a tortoise. After visiting this Chatham Island, they reached to the Albemarle Island. There also they had seen iguana, but the iguana of Albemarle Island were of different species. They were not same as the iguana of Chatham Island. After Albemarle Island, they went to the James Island. In the James Island, they had seen many finches. And what is the finches? These finches are actually small, colorful bird. Darwin has observed that these finches had different food habit. Some of them lived on cacti, some of them lived on leaves, L-E-A-V-E-S, leaves, pattiya, or some of them lived on insects. That means they were having different food habits. On the basis of their food habits, the structure of their beak, were also different. Darwin sat on a rock and drew the sketches of different finches in his notebook. James that time, he just roamed here and there and visited the places and saw the finches. Darwin has named these islands as the forgotten world, because this world or the situation of Galapagos were totally different from the present world. Now the present world, that doesn't mean the world of now, that means 2020. The present world is considered with the world of Darwin, that means 1835. That means whatever civilization or human socialization was there during 1835, Galapagos Island was totally different from that. The animals were not aware of the human existence, they were unaccustomed with human company, and the situation were totally different in the Galapagos Island. It seemed that it was one of the earliest island or one of the earliest time that Darwin had reached during his voyage. So through this story, we just have learned the different animals or species of Galapagos Island when Darwin had visited there in 1835. Thank you.